Very good morning to you all across the whole world. Today I've got a message for somebody wherever you are. My name is Evangelist Paul Mushonga of Ambassador of Light Evangelical Mission. And our mission is basically to touch lives according to the word of God. Because God called us to the work of the ministry in order to fulfill his divine purpose. We are living at a challenging time, a time that is unprecedented for the whole world. And I believe this message this morning will bring transformation and change into somebody's life. My message this morning is entitled Rebuilding Broken Lives, Cities and Nations. There are many people whose lives are upside down at this hour. There are many people whose lives are broken. There are many cities and nations whose lives are in turmoil. And it is the will of God to bring a restoration. It is the will of God to mend broken lives. But listen to me. This is why God had to call a man called Nehemiah in the book of Nehemiah. We had a godly assignment with a godly purpose in order to rebuild something which was broken. So it is in my heart that this three-part series on rebuilding broken lives, cities, and nations will basically touch your life. Remember, life on earth, it's very much temporary. We are temporarily resident on this earth. We are temporary citizens. But there is a greater home that awaits us. And it is of critical and utmost importance that you make the right choice and you make the right decision whilst you still have time. And this is the purpose of this sermon this morning. God laid this message in my heart at a time such as this for you to come to your senses. The Bible says the prodigal son, when he came back to his senses, he said, "Let me go back to my father's house." And I believe that this morning, somebody whose life is broken, somebody whose life is empty, cities that are broken, cities that are in turmoil, cities that are in confusion, nations that are in confusion, in turmoil, where nothing is working. I believe that it is God's purpose to bring a rebuilding process. It is God's purpose to bring restoration, peace, and joy to such nations. The Bible says in the book of John chapter 4 and verse 23, "But the hour cometh, and now is." So today is your day. This is the day to bring the rebuilding of your life. I know your life is empty now. I know your life is broken. But God wants to bring restoration into your life. God wants to bring life. The Bible says in the book of John chapter 10 verse 10, "The thief cometh to steal, kill, and destroy. But God came to give life, life in abundance, life in its fullness." My scripture reading this morning is in the book of Nehemiah. And I will focus on the book of Nehemiah chapter 1 from verse 3 to 5. And I read as follows. "And they said unto me," so this is Nehemiah basically, when his brethren, remember Nehemiah was in exile, and his brethren had paid him a visit. And as they paid him a visit, now they are updating him. They're updating him on what is happening in his home country. "And therefore now," the scripture begins and says, Nehemiah chapter 1 verse 3, 5. But I'll read verse 3. I'll read verse 3 at this moment in verse 4. "And they said unto me, the remnant that are left of the captivity there in the province are in great affliction." So those that had returned in exile, they are in great affliction and reproach. And where my message is, it says in this scripture, "The wall of Jerusalem," the wall of Jerusalem is also broken down. So underline, "The wall of Jerusalem also is broken down. And the gates thereof are burnt with fire." Verse 4. "And it came to pass, when I heard these words, that I sat down and wept, and mourned certain days, and fasted and prayed before the God of heaven." So Nehemiah is basically saying, when he was told by the brethren that the remnant that had returned from exile, they are experiencing great trouble. They are experiencing affliction. Life on earth, ladies and gentlemen, it's not simple. The Bible says in the book of Psalm 34 and verse 19, many are the afflictions of the righteous. But the good news is that the Lord delivereth them from all. Many are the afflictions of a righteous man. Many are the afflictions of mankind. Many are the afflictions of they that know the Lord Jesus Christ. But when you go through affliction, when you go through brokenheartedness, remember this, the Lord will deliver you out of all your brokenness. So God is a good God. He is a loving God, and He wants to bring rebuilding. This is why Nehemiah said, when I heard these words, I sat down and I wept. So this was a reflection process. This was an introspection process. Let me tell you, God is more than ready and willing to rebuild your life. That one is an uncontested statement. God is more than ready and willing to rebuild your life. Psalm 102 and verse 16. For the Lord will rebuild Zion. For the Lord will rebuild Zion and appear in his glory. The question that I pose to you this morning, are you ready? Are you ready for God to bring a rebuilding process of your life? Are cities ready to receive his word in order for cities to be rebuilt? Are nations ready to acknowledge that he is the God who is supreme, who is above everything? The God who is the creator of heaven and earth? Are cities ready to receive his word in order to bring a rebuilding process? Remember this, the rebuilding process of your life, of cities and of nations, it starts with you. It starts with you. It starts with leaders. It starts with rulers. It starts with kings. It starts with presidents. It starts with us as a people. How does it start with us as a people? By acknowledging that things are broken down. The brethren who had returned from exile when they visited Nehemiah, they acknowledged first that the broken walls, that Jerusalem lies in a broken state. The wall of Jerusalem is also broken down. So there was acknowledgement. There was no denial there. Some people's lives are broken down, yet they will not experience the touch of God. Yet they will not experience the move of God. Why? Because they are in denial that there is something that is broken in their lives. What therefore do you need to do? Number one, you need to reflect and introspect. Nehemiah said, I sat down and wept. That was a reflection process. That was a moment of introspection. Nehemiah said, when I heard these words, I sat down and wept. This is a personal reflection. This is a personal introspection. If your life is to be rebuilt, you need to look yourself in the eye and acknowledge that there is something that is broken down. So we as a people, you as a person, you as an individual, nations and cities, we need to go through a process of reflection. We need to go through a process of introspection. We need to acknowledge that there is something that is broken down. And we need to come to a position whereby we know that the only way out is only through the Lord Jesus Christ. Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 8. He is the same yesterday. He is the same today. And he is the same forevermore. And he is more than willing to rebuild your life. Because he is a loving God. Because he is a caring God. One thing that you need to understand is that you need to understand that it is never too late to rebuild. Some people may be saying, man of God, I am too old for the rebuilding process to take place. Well, I have good news for you. It is never too late to rebuild. God is never late in any situation. God is never late. God comes at the exact time, at the exact moment for your life to be rebuilt. But you may delay yourself by running away from him. by having self-denial that something is wrong in your life. Many lives, many cities and nations lie in ruin, yet God wants to rebuild. Where is the problem? I said, many lives, many cities, many nations, they lie in ruin. Yet God wants to bring a rebuilding process. Where is the problem? I'll touch on basically two things. Number one is the arrogance and pride of men and women. The arrogance and pride of men and women of this generation. Pride cometh before the fall of a man. When there is arrogance, you don't accept that there is something that is broken in your life. Yet in reality and in practicality and in truth, something is broken. John chapter 8 and verse 32. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. But you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. So the rebuilding process starts with us taking away our pride, shedding away the jacket of arrogance that many are putting within this generation. The lack of humility and acknowledgement that I am broken down. It will hinder the rebuilding process in your life. So the problem number one is the arrogance and pride of men and women of this generation. Number two is the lack of humility and acknowledgement that I am broken down. The failure to acknowledge that we are broken down. Because of this pride and arrogance, the failure to realize that without God being the epicenter of whatever we plan, we are doomed to fail. So if we fail to acknowledge that there is something broken down, if we fail to acknowledge that God is the epicenter of everything that we must seek to do, then the rebuilding process will not take place. Listen to this. It is easier to build, but it is more painful to rebuild. That is why you need to lean not on your own understanding. The Bible says, commit all your plans to the Lord and they will succeed. Therefore, you do not need to lean on your own understanding. If you lean, ladies and gentlemen, if we lean on our own understanding, we are doomed to fail to realize that God wants the best for us. We are doomed to fail to realize that God wants to rebuild our city. We are doomed to fail to realize that God wants to build our nations. We are doomed to fail to realize that God wants to rebuild my life. Listen, I don't care. I don't care what psychological book you've read. I don't care which level of philosophy that you have achieved and accomplished in this life. I don't care which sociological book or which sociological level you have attained in this life. If God is not the epicenter of what we are trying to do, it's impossible for God to rebuild your life. Yet, your life is broken. But because of your pride and arrogance, it brings a limitation. So number one, you need to be realistic and truthful to yourself. You need to go through a process of self-introspection. You need to go through a process of self-reflection. And after you've gone through this process, then you need to acknowledge that something is broken. Rebuilding broken lives. Rebuilding broken cities. Rebuilding broken nations. And it is the will of God that this is achieved in your life. Now, the number two thing that you need to do. So number one, I said you need to be realistic and truthful to yourself. Number two, what do you need to do? You need to read and study the Word of God. You need to read your Bible and you need to study the Word of God. And this must be accompanied by prayer and fasting. This must be accompanied by prayer and fasting. So number one, you need to read and study the Word of God accompanied by prayer and fasting. Listen to what Nehemiah said. Nehemiah said, when I heard these things, I sat down and wept. Then he said, I mourned, I fasted and prayed before the God of heaven. Prayer changes things. Fasting Listen to, when you fast, you are humbling yourself. Fasting is humility. You're humbling yourself before the throne of mercy, before the throne of glory, before the throne of love. So when you pray and when you fast and when you are humbling yourself, why are you doing this? So that God will give you the divine direction. So that God will give you the tools that are important for the rebuilding of your life. This is a true and worthwhile saying. If you need him to be involved in the rebuilding of your life, if we need him to be involved in the rebuilding of cities and nations, we must know him. We must know him. Not only that, we must acknowledge him as our Lord and personal Savior. So we must know him. Listen to me this morning. Wherever you are across the entire end of the earth, my question to you this morning is, God is more than, but my question to you is, do you know him? Do you know him? He is more than ready. God has always been ready in order to bring change and transformation into your life. But listen to me. He cannot change your he cannot rebuild your life until and unless if you know him. He is more than ready and he is more than willing. This is why Nehemiah said, I sat down and wept. I mourned. I prayed and I fasted. To who? To the God of heaven. Wherever you are, your life may be broken down and you don't know where to restart. Your life may be upside down. Your life may be in confusion. Your life may be in turmoil. But I've got good news to you this morning. God wants to rebuild your life. God wants to bring change into your life. God wants to give you a fresh start. Listen, we have all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. We have all gone astray. We have all gone astray and failed to abide by the standard that God wants us to achieve and attain. But the good news is that God is more than ready to bring a fresh start into our lives, into our cities, and into our nations. And ladies and gentlemen, we live in a generation whereby leaders need to introspect themselves. The rebuilding of our lives starts by acknowledging that there is something wrong. The rebuilding of cities need to start by us acknowledging that there is something that is broken in our cities. The rebuilding of nations need to begin and start by us acknowledging that our nations are broken down. We have gone astray. We listen to me. We have disappointed God. We have disappointed God. And we need to come to a position where we need to acknowledge to God that, Lord, we have sinned against you. Lord, we have gone astray according to your ways, according to your standards. And Lord, may you begin the rebuilding process of my life. Lord, may you begin the rebuilding process of my city. Lord, may you begin the rebuilding process of my nation. We need to come to a position of humbling ourselves. As a nation, we need to come to our knees. The Bible says, every knee shall bow down, and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God himself. So we need to come as a nation before his throne of mercy and acknowledge that our nation is broken down. And we need you, oh God, for this rebuilding process. You may be listening to me this morning, and you don't know Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You don't know him. You don't know, you're saying, man of God, I don't know. I don't know about this Jesus of Nazareth that you're preaching about. I don't have a personal relationship with him. You may have heard about him, and yet you don't have a personal relationship with him. You may have heard about him, and yet you don't have a personal relationship with him. Let me tell you. He is more than ready and willing to accept you as his son and daughter and to be involved and lead the way in rebuilding your life. Listen to me. The best decision that anybody can make, the best decision that any man can make, the best decision that any woman can make is to acknowledge and accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. The Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 10, verse 9 to 10, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus Christ and believe in your heart that Jesus Christ died and God raised him from the dead, then you shall be then you shall be saved. Ladies and gentlemen, rebuilding broken lives, cities, and nations. It is the will of God that the rebuilding process begins and takes place now. So this morning, wherever you are, I urge you to sit down and be honest and be truthful to yourself and introspect your life. Where do you stand in your relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ? We need to introspect cities. Where do cities stand in relation to the Lord Jesus Christ? Where do nations stand in relation to the Lord Jesus Christ? There was acknowledgement that Jerusalem was lying in ruins. The wall is broken down in Jerusalem. And when Nehemiah heard that the wall is broken down in Jerusalem, the man of God was touched. This morning, I know as I minister to you, there are many lives that are broken down. There are many lives that are empty. There are cities that are broken down. There are cities that are lying in ruins. There are nations that are lying broken down. And God is speaking this morning. We need to come to a position where we need to come before the throne of mercy, where we need to come before the throne of glory. He is a merciful God. He is a loving God. He is a caring God. And He wants to bring restoration in our lives. He wants to bring restoration in our cities. He wants to bring restoration in our nations. This morning, you may be saying, I don't know Him. I have heard about Him, but I don't know Him. You may not have heard about Him, but His name is Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Bible says, Romans chapter 10, verse 9 to 10, is for you this morning. So, if you don't know Him, if you don't have a personal relationship with Him, as I say this prayer, you may say this prayer wherever you are. It's called the prayer of salvation. It is what will bring you into a personal relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. So you may repeat after me and say, Lord Jesus Christ, I have heard your servant minister and preach this morning. And I open my heart, Lord. And I receive you as my Lord and personal Savior. With my own mouth, I proclaim the Lord Jesus Christ. And in my heart, I acknowledge that Jesus Christ died and you raised Him from the dead. Satan, I publicly denounce you and I have nothing to do with you. From now onwards, I totally belong to the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Simple as it may seem, but let me tell you, in the realms of the spirit, something profound has happened. Your life has become a new life in Christ Jesus. Now God will begin to bring a rebuilding process into your life. You are now a new creation. You are now a new creation in Christ Jesus. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 17, if any man be in Christ Jesus, he or she is a new creation. The old is gone and the new has come. Your life will never remain the same. Let me bring you assurance. Your life has been transformed. From now onwards, when you pray, God will answer and hear your prayers. Because now there is a personal relationship with Him. And His name is Jesus. If you had gone astray, This is the day for you to be reconciled back to the Lord Jesus Christ. If you have made mistakes, fine, we all make mistakes. But this is a day of reconciliation. Ladies and gentlemen, let us unite in intercessory prayer. Let us unite in intercessory prayer for broken lives, for broken cities, and for broken nations. Remember, I said this is a three-part series. So next week, I will also release and I will continue with this message because it's a three-part series. Today, I've just dwelt in the book of Nehemiah chapter 1, verse 3 to 4. I've just dealt from between verse 1, verse 3 and 4. And I will continue with other verses. But what I would like to do for us in this week is for you and I And for everybody across the entire ends of the earth to unite in intercessory prayer for broken lives, for broken cities, and for broken nations. The wall of Jerusalem lies broken down. The wall is broken down. There was acknowledgement. There was acknowledgement. I know that there are many lives that are broken down. I know that there are many lives that lie in ruins. I know that there are many cities that lie in ruins. I know that there are many nations that lie in ruins. But listen to me, I've got good news. The only way out is the Lord Jesus Christ. Whatever we plan, listen to me, because of COVID-19, nations are in ruins, nations are in desolate, lives have been turned upside down. But listen to me, the only way out to restoration, the only way out to rebuilding is when we put the Lord Jesus Christ first. The Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 6 and verse 33, but seek ye first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these other things shall be added unto us, shall be given unto us. So we need to seek him first. Listen to me, I know we have gone to the best of universities. I know in our day and age, we have got the best brains. I know we've got the best professors of our lifetime. I know we've got the best doctors of our lifetime. I know we have the best knowledge of our lifetime. But listen to me, intellectualism without the Lord Jesus Christ is the epicenter of whatever we are doing. It is folly, it is nothing, it is imbecility. And we will fail dismally, and our lives will remain broken, and our cities will remain desolate, and our nations will become worse off. It is very surprising. We have attained the best knowledge, and yet we are failing to run nations and cities. Why? Because we have removed the Lord Jesus Christ as the epicenter of what we think that because of our intellectualism, our knowledge, then God does not matter. It is a joke. It is a joke, because without the Lord Jesus Christ leading the way for us, listen, our knowledge is limited. Our knowledge is limited. But the moment that we acknowledge the supremacy of God, then God in his profound wisdom and in his profound way, he will make a way for us. Because he is a caring God, because he is a loving God. I thank you, and may you like on YouTube, may you like our message, may you subscribe to our message, and we'll be posting regularly. Like I said, next week we'll continue with this message, and God will basically increase you. God will basically open ways for you. Listen, as we unite in prayer, prayer shifts and changes things. So as we unite in prayer this week for broken lives, for broken cities and broken nations, I know that the hand of God will move and many lives will be restored. Before I end this session, I would like to pray. I would like to thank God for this time and opportunity. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father, I give you all glory and all adoration, O God. Thank you for everything. Thank you for your message, oh God. This is not my message, oh God. I'm just a servant. I'm just a vessel, oh God. But may you touch lives that are broken, oh God. May you touch lives that are in turmoil, lives that are in confusion at this hour, oh God. You are never too late to intervene in lives, oh God. Father, I pray this morning, oh God, may your glory be experienced across the entire ends of the earth, oh God. I know, Father, there are many cities that are lying in ruins, oh God. There are many cities that are lying in desolate, oh God. There are many cities that are broken-hearted, oh God. But this morning, Father, may your glory, oh God, come over those cities. May your glory come over nations that are in ruins, nations that are desolate, nations that are broken apart, oh God. Father, there is nothing that is impossible with you, oh God. May you move, oh God. May you move, oh God. Father, we have sinned and come short of the glory of your ways, oh God. But Father, this morning, Father, we acknowledge our mistakes, oh God. We acknowledge, oh God, our mistakes before your throne of glory, mercy, and peace, oh God. Father, forgive us, oh God. Forgive us, oh God. May your hand of restoration move over nations. May your hand of restoration move over lives, oh God. May your hand of restoration move over nations, oh God. You are a God who is supreme, oh God. You are a God who is loving and caring, oh God. Father, thank you, Lord. For I know there are testimonies. There are testimonies, oh God. Because I know you are touching the broken life of that man. I know you are touching the broken life of that woman, oh Jehovah. Maka zuba, maka prasito. Meliko la baka zaka zala pakaraseto. Mekin tele, mekin tino, mika dosido. Rekezuka la bakarasito kabraso bobo. Mekeresito, mika tozo, maka tuso, maka talias. Lekito lekito lika zuga gaba gaba guso. Mekere sintana maka duka togo repeke presido. I know you are touching that broken city, oh God. You are bringing restoration, my Lord. I know you are touching that broken nation, oh God. Oh yes, you are bringing restoration. You are bringing restoration. You are rebuilding, my Father. Oh, for the glory of your name, for the glory of your kingdom. Lazaba karakata makarasito kebresito kapazuka lepre ebredino abakasokato laka lakatuno lakatezo likarakanta kanta rakazaba bakabrakadino kabrasodo. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, O Lord Jesus. May you have a blessed week. May you have a blessed week. May he restore your life. May your city be restored. May your nation be restored. He is a loving God. He is a caring God. He loves you. He cares about you. And he is more than willing to bring change and transformation into your life. Be blessed and be blessed. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.